Hey guys, it's Meagan, and this is the first video on the Art School Dropouts channel. So basically, it'll be me, Kaden, and Katie on this channel, and we will upload every week. I'm Tuesdays, Katie's Thursdays, and Kaden is Saturday or Sunday, I believe. So yeah. But basically today, I'm just going to help you guys get to know me better, and I'm going to show you 20 of random favorite things of mine. So yeah, let's get started. So the first thing is this Blue Neighborhood CD. I think this is amazing. Troye Sivan is definitely an amazing upcoming artist. So yeah, and my favorite song off of here would probably be Youth or Suburbia. Yes, love the CD. My mom actually bought me this for Christmas. It came out in December, but I got it like a week or so after for Christmas. And I knew I was getting it because I picked it out and then my mom gave it to me on Christmas. So yeah. The second thing is this DIY kind of brush holder, which I don't have brushes in because they're all over the place, but like, yeah. So basically, I needed a brush holder and I'm cheap and I'm kind of broke right now. And I was looking in the kitchen and I had always seen these DIY videos of like the mason jars, but they painted them, they're all like dirty. So I just grabbed one and I just like put my makeup brushes in there because, yeah. Why not? So yeah, just big brush and you know the deal. Which speaking of, I need to add some highlights. So yeah. Anyways, let's see the third thing. Is this mascara? It's the Voluminous Superstar mascara. I think it's amazing. Who is this by? I don't know. But anyways, yes. I actually, funny story, my mom bought this because I was like, she's like, I need some new mascara. And I was like, well, okay. And then we saw this and I was like, you should get this one. Then I tried it and I was like, damn, it's cool. And basically, like, it has two steps. So this is number one and it's white. Like, weird, right? You're like, white? Why would I put white on eyelashes? But it comes pretty clear. And that's the primer. And then this is the mascara part. And it's like a curved brush, so it like works better, but yeah. I have it on right now. It's not for like, I mean, I'm sure if you layered it, it'd be like great for like heavy mascara, but it's just light. So yeah. Also this right here, this Paul Mitchell original leave-in conditioner. This stuff is amazing. I've been using this for over a year now. It's leave-in conditioner and it makes my hair super super soft. I have it in my hair right now. I mean, you can't feel my hair, but trust me, it makes it soft. So yeah, it's great because I don't like to condition my hair. I have red hair. The roots are showing. I need to re-dye it, but I have red hair and don't like to wash it more than I have to, so yeah. And the next item, I'm not really sure which number that was. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think this is number 5. This is this Neutrogena Rapid Clear Stubborn Acne Cleanser because I have acne, if you can't tell. I mean, you probably can't right now, but I do. So this comes in handy. It's just Rapid Clear Stubborn Acne Cleanser. Benzoyl peroxide acne medicine treats even stubborn acne. It's by Neutrogena. I actually bought this because I was breaking out really bad at the time, and I was like, this isn't gonna work. So I went to Ulta and I saw this and I was like, maybe I should try it. So yeah. The next thing is these. This is by Lavu Cosmetics. They're amazing. Yeah. And this one is the moisturizer, the Day Moisturizing Cream. And I love this. Oh shit. Y'all, I'm clumsy as hell, if you already know. But, yeah. I love to use this before I do my makeup. It just makes the application go 100 times smoother, like, without makeup, it's like, but with makeup, I mean, with this, it's like, yes, get it? So, I love this, and it just moisturizes the skin, and sometimes I even wear this by itself, so. And then the next thing, which is also by Lavu, is the facial exfoliating gel. This stuff is amazing. If you ever need to like exfoliate your face or whatnot, it just gets on like the dead skin, I believe, and it just makes your face feel soft. So yeah. The next thing is this. This is the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette. I absolutely love this thing. this is great for pale people, I think, because these highlight shades work great. And this color right here, excuse my nails, yeah. This is a great color to contour with. I contoured with it today, and I'm pale, as you can tell, so it works well. Yeah. And the highlight shade's pretty good. As you can tell, I've hit pan on it. So, like, let me show you this highlight. Yeah, it's so pretty. I love it. So, yeah, I love to use this. I also got that for Christmas. So, yeah. I don't know what item that was, but, like, okay. This primer. This is the only primer I ever use. Guys, I'm so clumsy. I just dropped this in the trash can. Okay. This is the Bare Minerals Prime Time Primer. I don't know if they sell this anymore. I bought this a while ago, but I don't put on makeup every day, so I still have it. And it's amazing. You just put it on under your foundation. I usually put this on after I moisturize, so it just makes your makeup glide on, especially combined with that moisturizer. It works wonders. I tell you, girl. I tell you. I ain't gonna lie to you. So, anyways. Oh, the next thing, this is a lifesaver, is this blending Real Techniques Beauty Sponge Complexion Blender Thingy-Mabobber. It's like a beauty blender. It's amazing to blend your makeup out with. I actually used a kabuki brush today. I used this one. I know I'm holding that wrong, okay? I used this brush today to do my makeup, but I always use a sponge. Like, if you are a fan of my Younow, you know I've been using the sponge every time. So, you know, that's also another one of my must-haves. So, yeah. Also, I have this hair straightener. I have curly hair naturally, and this just works great for my hair. So, yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about other things that aren't, like, beauty related. My favorite show on Netflix is The Secret Life of an American Teenager. Let's just take a moment. Bitch. That is my show. I love that show. It's my baby. It's my life. I still find myself rewatching it, and I've watched all of it. Last summer, I don't know if you know, you probably don't, but I may or may not have not slept for like 3 weeks, 2 weeks, binge watching every single episode. But you know, whatever. That's life. It's great. So I'm horrible. I'm just kidding, but like honestly, y'all probably did too, so also Pretty Little Liars been toying with my emotions for like 4 years, 5 years now. I've been watching it since I was a little one, like sixth grade. It's been messing with my emotions for years now. Like, yes, just you, if you watch it, you just know what I mean, girl or boy, whatever. And the Fosters, that's really good too. You know what? Just Freeform as a channel altogether, which y'all probably heard ABC Family changed its name to Freeform, but yeah, so that's great. I just love the Fosters. I don't know why, but I'm like totally Team Brawley, and I know it's like bad, but I love it so much. So okay, so now I have some books to share with you, my favorite books. I absolutely love this book, Peep the Top, I know, but it's called My Life Next Door by Huntley Fitzpatrick. It's one of my favorite books. I actually read this book last year for this project called LRP. It's a literary research project. But I read it by the recommendation of my friend Jessica. She had read it and I was like, girl, I want this. And so I bought it. It's amazing. I don't know if y'all probably do know what Wattpad is. Wattpad. Pretty sure this book like originated on there. So it's pretty great. So yeah. This book is freaking amazing. I didn't get this at anybody's recommendation but my own. I was in Target and I love to look at the book section because like why not? And it's called Sublime. And it's amazing. It's a beautiful, haunting read. I'm gonna read the back because I just love it so much. It says, a boy emerges, wild dark curls fall on his eyes. In that moment, her silent heart twists beneath the empty walls of her chest. This is the first physical sensation she has had since waking under a sky full of falling leaves. Something about the light in his eyes when he looks up makes her ache to share herself with him. But share what? Her mind? Her body? How can she share things that she doesn't know? So it's a romantic and unforgettable story of first love. It's amazing. Love this book. It's so good. Yeah. And then this one's To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. It's amazing. You guys have probably seen it in like Target and stuff. And this one says, when I write, I hold nothing back. I write like he'll never read it because he never will. Every secret thought, every careful of observation, everything I've saved up inside me, I put it all in the letter. When I'm done, I seal it, I address it, and then I put it in my tail hat box. They're not love letters in the strictest sense of the world. My letters are for who don't want to be in love anymore. They're for goodbye. So that's amazing. And then my Connor Franta book. I absolutely love this book. Y'all probably know what it is, but I actually got it autographed by him. So yeah, those are a few of my favorite things. I think that was 20. It might have been more, might have been less, give or take. But yeah, I absolutely love these things. And I hope I maybe inspired you to get some of these things or maybe look into similar things or just help you get to know me better. I love you guys and I'll see you next Tuesday. Bye!